Good morning, my dear student. This is the continued part of phylum Platyhelminthes. So in the last video, you have studied the morphological structure of Taenia solium or tapeworm. And in this video, you are studying with the life cycle of Taenia solium or tapeworm. So the life history of Taenia solium, it is complicated and digenetic, nothing but it consisting of two hosts, that is the primary host or definitive host, that is the man, and the secondary host or intermediate host, that is the pig. So the division in the eggs, they start while they are inside the uterus itself. So the division of the eggs, that what we call it as cleavage, the first cleavage is unequal, so that a large vitelline cell and a small embryonic cell is formed. So this embryonic cell undergo repeated division and forms a solid ball of cell, and that what we call it as the morula. In this slide you can see the zygote. So zygote in eggshell, that means within the eggshell, and it undergoes a cleavage, and you can see the two cell stage, and later on it enters into the morula stage, that is early morula, and then it enters into the late morula stage, which consisting of different types of cells. So the next, it is the hexacanth larva or larval stage. The outer cells of the morula secretes a thick striated coat, which is made up of chitin, and later on it hardens into a secondary shell, or what we call it as embryophore, which is present inside the eggshell. So below to the embryophore, you can see the presence of basement membrane. So the inner cells of the morula forms an embryo which acquires six chitinous hooks posteriorly, and this hooked embryo is called as hexacanth. Hexa means six, and you can see six chitinous hooks which is formed from the inner cells of the morula. So the hexacanth with its primary capsule, shell, thick embryophore, basement membrane, and two hexacanth membrane is called as oncosphere. So here in this slide you can see the C picture, which we call it as the hexacanth, where you can see six number of chitinous hooks. And the A picture that shows, that is the young oncosphere, which consisting of a young eggshell and embryo four. So later on during development, mature oncosphere, that is the B picture, which consisting of, that is hexacanth with primary capsule, shell, thick embryophore, basement membrane, and two hexacanth membranes, and total it is called as oncospheres. So the development of egg up to the formation of this oncosphere takes place inside the uterus of the gravid proglottids, and the further development is not possible inside the host body. So the gravid proglottids, they detach from the body of a parasite and come out along with the host feces. So these infect the secondary host when pig feeds upon the contaminated feces. So infection to secondary host. So the gravid proglottids, they disintegrate or they divide. Those The oncospheres, they are eaten up by the pigs along with the human feces. So after reaching the stomach of the pig, the capsule shell and the other membranes which are present around the hexacanth, they are dissolved and there will be liberation of hexacanth. So like that, there are numerous hexacanth which are free in the stomach, and the embryonic membranes of the oncospheres, they are get dissolved. So when they dissolved all these membranes, they easily bore the intestinal wall with the help of hooks and they enter the bloodstream. They start traveling through the heart and they enter into the muscles of various parts in the body, like it also enter into the muscles of tongue, heart, liver and shoulder. So once it has reached the muscles, they loosens the hooks and increase their size and acquires fluid filled central cavity, then encysted in a cuticular covering to become cysticeri or bladder worms. So here the cysticeri or bladder worm, which is a, what we call it as the infective stage. So here in this picture you can see the maturation of bladder worm. So here by the process of invagination, you can see a presence of fluid filled central cavity which is present, which is what we call it as the bladder, which is surrounded by bladder wall. In the second picture, you can see the cysticerus with proscolex. Scolex, which is the first part, body part of tapeworm. So here, this cysticerus, which consisting of, that is the succus and the rostral hooks which are present, which can bore through the intestinal wall of the host. So later in the third picture, you can see the scolex part which gets out from the, that is the bladder, from the bladder. So the next picture, fourth picture, you can see the cysticerus with evaginated scolex. So the bladder which gets, that means the from the bladder, the evaginated scolex emerges out, which consisting of, that is the neck and the head portion, that is the proscolex, which consisting of hooks and the hooks and the suckers. And the last one, so in the last picture, the fifth picture, you can see the bladder or the cysticerus worm, which consisting of the neck, which is budding of the proglottids. So you can see the strobilated neck, and along with that you can see the proscolex, which consisting of suckers and the hooks. So next it is the transmission to primary host. The further development of bladder worm or cysticerus, that takes place only inside the definitive host, that is the man. Infection of man occurs when inadequately cooked pork infected with bladder worms is eaten. The cysticeri become active in the intestine. The scolex takes a firm hold of intestinal wall to the host. The bladder is thrown off and the neck starts budding off the segments and an adult tapeworm is formed. 10 to 12 weeks proscolex is converted into adult thania solium. So in this picture you can see the thania solium inside the man's intestine, which we call it as definitive host or the primary host. So in this picture you can clearly see the flowchart representing the life history of Taenia solium. So adult tapeworm in the human gut, fertilized eggs in mature proglottids, egg capsule in gravid proglottids, oncospheres in gravid proglottids. Gravid proglottids or oncospheres in human feces. So that will be out from the human body with the feces. So those oncospheres in the gut of the pig, that is due to coprophagy. Hexacanth in the gut. So the hexacanth in the intestinal blood vessels. Hexacanth in the heart, hexacanth in the muscles. That means they get to travel in the different body parts. Later on, when they enter into the muscles, they become cysticeri or bladder worms. So after when it reaches the muscle, cysticeres in the striped muscles, that is which are where you can see, that is the measly pork. The cysticeres in the gut of the human beings, and later on it will develop as an adult tapeworm in the human gut. In this picture, diagrammatical life cycle, you can clearly see the different stages of Taenia solium, where exactly the life cycle which takes place between man and the pig. So the next part, it is the pathogenesis. Pathogenesis, it is nothing but the disease which is caused by Taenia solium. So the Taenia solium infection can progress to a disease state in 10 days or as low as 10 years. The disease which is caused by, that is Taenia solium or tapeworm, we call it as taeniasis. Typically, adult tapeworm does not produce eggs in stool for 8 to 12 weeks. Most intestinal infection are, you can see asymptomatic, includes abdominal pain, weight loss, appendicitis, obstruction of bile ducts, like that. And some common complication which includes, that is you can see complication in pancreatic ducts and mild eosinophilia you can see. So the most important health problem, that is infection which is caused by cysticeri, and the infection we call it as cysticerosis. So the eggs that pass through the stomach, so either from ingestion or reverse peristalsis, hatch in the small intestine and they penetrate the intestinal wall and distributed throughout the body in the circulatory system. So the common sites of infection are all the skeletal muscles and the brain. Cysticeri in the muscles may cause weakness and the pain, whereas encysement in the eyes, they can cause blindness, and the brain when it develops, that will form epilepsy. So the treatment for the taeniasis, that is anti-helminthic drug with CCL4 content, and drugs, they remove only the strobila part or the body segment. But when there is the scoliosis, if they are present, they have to be removed by surgical operations. So controlling measures. Infection may be checked by the destruction of developmental stages like the oncospheres and cysticeri. Oncosphere may be destroyed through proper disposal of human feces by sewage system, or preventing pigs from visiting human feces. Thank you.